What's going on, you guys? Jacobrdoty here, back from another vlog, and we're back at the standard place, which is this warehouse area. I've used this place for lots of videos. Some of you guys actually know where this is, and that's pretty cool. But today I'm gonna talk about one of my favorite things about my car. It was one of the major things that I had to do to any car I buy, regardless if it's the Mustang, if it's a daily driver or whatever, because I enjoy music. And judging by this title, you probably know it's gonna be talking about the sound system. Now for this car, I bought a base model Mustang GT. So that means it came with nothing fancy really. I mean, I got the technology package. That was pretty much it. What the technology package does is it gave me Bluetooth and steering wheel controls. And that was really all I wanted. I wanted steering wheel controls. I've never had that before. My other car is a 2005, so it was pretty old. Just didn't have those steering wheel controls. But with this one, I got that because I upgraded, or whoever bought the car upgraded to the technology package.
In case you guys are new to the channel, I have this bagged 2013 5.0. It's on XO luxury wheels. It's got carbon fiber everywhere. It's following this black and yellow theme. And it currently sits like this. So I have the GT500 grills, everything in there. So yeah, this is what it looks like currently. I'm just catching it at sunset, so hopefully you can see everything. But yeah, it's fully blacked out. All the tint is in there. And surprisingly, you can see through it just fine. I also have this JATO Performance steering wheel, fully carbon fiber, but there's those steering wheel controls I was talking about. So right there, I can control all my audio and my voice control, which I've actually never done, but at least I could change songs, take a phone call and all that, because that was pretty important to me. On the GT Premiums, there's usually a big subwoofer right here, and on mine, I just have this speaker. So a GT Premium would have this speaker and a subwoofer here. I think it's an 8-inch. It's not the greatest. I mean, it's a good system for stock, but for me, I wanted something a little bit better, so I upgraded my speakers in here. So this is usually like a coaxial, which is like a, I don't know, a 5x7 or 6x9 or whatever those are, but this actually got upgraded to be component. So this is a 4.5-inch woofer, I believe, with a little tweeter. So that way I get a different range. I don't know if you can even see it in there. See how it's yellow in there? That's actually the Pioneer system, or the Pioneer speakers. That's one of the woofers. Just that little flash of yellow.
Now for wanting to get technical, these are the Pioneer, and I'm gonna read it off Amazon to where I got it. The TSD1330C 5.25-inch component speaker package. So it's right there. It says currently unavailable. I don't know if they have an upgraded version. It looks like they probably have an upgraded version. But these bad boys were maybe 70 bucks. And these alone I did before the subwoofer separately. I wired everything in there. I got these Metra adapters. So everything just plugged right in. I didn't have to cut any stock wiring. These literally run off my factory head unit. Those made a very big difference. They made it very clear. And I only have them up in the front. So I still have my rear deck ones. I would suggest doing that if you guys have a base model. Just get some better speakers. Now these aren't even the best ones. If I was to go again, I'd probably get some JLs or something like that, because, now let me show you this.
Let me show you this after I empty out all my crap.
Got the crane camera bag, which I don't want to drop everything out of. And kind of pick up some straw hat pieces, because I had a straw hat that literally exploded in the back of my car. That should be good.
This right here has been kind of shown off in some videos. You guys have seen it and asked a lot of questions about it. Don't mind this. This is a nice little detailing supply. Shout out Liquid X. I always got it on deck. What these babies are two JL Audio W3 10-inch subwoofers in a custom ported box. I wanted a custom box because I didn't just want this giant rectangle in my trunk. I wanted something that actually looks good. So that's what I got. I got this one from Zenclosures. I gave them the specs for the speakers, which I think was like 1.25 square foot.
Now, when it comes to ported speakers, it does matter how much room the box has. That means that there's an optimal amount of room and airspace that these boxes or these subwoofers need for the box. And yeah, that's definitely serious stuff, because if not, you can actually prematurely kill your subwoofer. It'll just be a bunch of bad issues. Don't try to push it into a little box. Just get the speaker in the box that fits. And because this is a tight space, I'm talking really tight.
So tight, in fact, that I actually had to take off this panel when I slid it in. And the way I got it in was like angled that way, then slid in this way. I think I even popped off this rubber trim a little bit. Yeah, this thing was insane. Like I finagled this thing in there, and I don't want to take it out ever.
Oh man.
We're running out of light and a freaking train wants to come. Oh yeah, that's gonna be great stuff. Hi train!
now the other part of this is not only a box, not only the speakers, but also what's powering it. So what's powering mine is a 1200 watt Phoenix Gold amp. And I actually got this amp used, but I realized that it's actually a very good brand. So I went ahead and just got it. One of my buddies actually knew the guy, so I kind of trusted the seller, because that's the thing with these amps is if they blow, I mean, they're the ones that power these freaking subwoofers. So if they blow, you have nothing to power these subwoofers and it's just gonna be a dead speaker. And you just don't want that thing to shoot off a bunch of power, blow your subwoofer, or just not give it enough power and it doesn't sound good.
But back behind that wall is actually an LC2i.
And what this LC2i does is it actually taps into the rear deck speakers that are on the rear deck.
They're literally like right there and there. There's like the speakers hanging down that you could probably see if I didn't have a subwoofer in there.
But this LC2i allows you to tap into those speakers, transmit the signal, do some magic that I don't quite totally understand, but it makes some magic to where it'll make a subwoofer signal that can go into an amplifier and then into these subwoofer speakers. Yeah, that's basically what's in there. I think that's 80 bucks. The amp is around 300 or 400 bucks. I mean, you can get almost any brand. JATO makes theirs, probably 500 bucks or so. The speakers are like 250 each, 200 each if you get them on a good deal. I think my subwoofer box was about 100 bucks, 150. Yeah, I think like maybe 150, 100 bucks. I don't know. But it was a good deal too.
These door speakers were what, 100 bucks a pair, even if you upgraded to them. And if you can do it yourself, that's awesome. But I actually had, let me shout them out. I had Elite Audio Intent do mine just because I trust them a lot more. They do very clean installs. And in fact, I actually had them mount down the box. And Zach, who's one of their workers there, didn't want to screw into my car, which I really appreciate. So thank you, Zach. He actually made a custom bracket that holds this box in that doesn't even screw into my car or any of my body panels.
The way it works is it kind of acts like a hook, because when I would gun it, my subwoofer box would like slide back. I'm sure you guys have that issue because the carpet's so slippery. Haven't had any issues after he made that mount. It literally sits right there. I mean, every time I'd pop my trunk, I'd have to, you know, shove the speakers all over the place, and it was kind of a hassle. And plus, I didn't want to damage them if they hit something. So yeah, shout out to you, Zach. Shout out to Elite Audio Intent. If you guys are in the Sacramento area and you need them to make some audio upgrades, go ahead, check them out, tell them I sent you. I swear they're gonna hook you up big time. They're the authorized JATO Audio, and they're kind of the ones that got me on this whole JATO Audio hype. This setup can definitely draw a lot of power, so I'm gonna go ahead and start up the car, and that way you guys can hear a little startup, maybe give it a little revs, because I'm over here in this industrial area.
That clip the audio, but I hope that gives you guys a little idea of how this baby sounds. And oh, look at those lights, baby. Woohoo! Yeah, this baby's looking nice. I love it at this dusk time. It's probably my favorite time of the day. Just this nice soft light. You have your headlights on, but you can still see outside. Yeah, this is definitely my favorite time.
It says it's totally royalty free, so we're gonna see if it works. Menu, select source, Bluetooth audio. Usually I put it right under that M and it's pretty good, so hopefully you guys can see me. Good highs, good sound. We're gonna get to the drop. Now that's nowhere near the loudest song I've had or the most bassy song, but what I prided myself on was having very crystal clear audio. So yeah, this thing sounds really good in all aspects. Again, I'm gonna only show like a couple of clips of me playing audio because it's just so hard to capture it through YouTube. So this is actually my intro song right here. Well, the instrumental.
talking shit about I, who will win in life. I'm alive, just took one
too. Way more bass.
Keep that vibe when we show up in collide.
Now, the best way for me to describe this would be just very clear, very clean audio with a good kick. I didn't want anything just like earth shattering. I wanted literally to poop all over the premium cars. I wanted a clean system, no big headaches, no big ol' like, I don't know. I just don't like the aftermarket head units unless sometimes they have like that really nice Tesla screen. I just wanted a nice clean setup so that way I could listen to music, enjoy it and everything like that. This has got to be a number one on every car I've ever had. Even my little daily driver Ford Focus has a JL Audio subwoofer. It's another 10 inch. I just really like JL Audio, and yeah, it's just one of those things that you gotta have in your car, at least in my mind. As I mentioned in my last video, we're gonna be doing some reading of the comments, so let's get into that really quick. We have the car in the background, so I figured, why not? We're gonna beat the light. I only have a couple minutes. You guys may not even see me, who knows? Lagars Deshar said, buy a truck. Trust me, dude, that is on my list of things I need to do. I want a truck super bad. Aiden Spangler said, move to Texas. Dude, I want to, I really do. I think in the future, I'll probably have a residency in Texas. It just might take some time because I really want to do it right. You guys seem to really love the intro. The intro was done by my buddy, Evan. He hit me up on Instagram. I sent him some clips. He freaking killed it. So shout out to you, Evan. You're the star on that one. You killed it. This guy is Ryan Miner. He's saying, yeah, dude, bro, having a black 5.0 is super tough to clean. Trust me, I know. We both want to wrap our cars. It's just going to be easier that way, and you don't have to deal with so much crap getting on your paint instantly. Another person asked me if I'm going to swap my gauge cluster to the premium one, which has the little screen. It might. I mean, if it falls into my lap or I get a great, insane deal on them, but for me, for $300, I don't know if it's something I totally want or totally need, because I have the Engage that shows me a lot of that stuff too. So I don't know. Alrighty guys, we're running out of light, so I'm gonna go ahead and wrap it up right here. As always, I hope you guys enjoyed. And if you did, then please comment, like, subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time.